The beginning of Luke's gospel, we have an account that Zechariah the priest was chosen by lot to enter into the temple. Chosen by lot, something like throwing dice or flipping a coin. Similarly, at the beginning of the Acts of the Apostles, Matthias was chosen similarly by lot to replace Judas among the 12. And the idea that of throwing a dice, of flipping a coin, it's not about luck or superstition. It's that sort of God's will is going to be shown not only through our own wisdom and sort of understanding and analysis, but we also have to sort of leave something open. But the idea, I think, is a little bit deeper than that. It's that when we serve before God as priests, we who are all who are baptized, who are the priesthood of the faithfulness to God, it is not by our own strength or brilliance or skill. Because something chosen by lot, well, it could have been anybody. Which means that when I am serving before God, I am nothing special. And so Peter, in the Gospels that we're hearing during these days, talks big. He says, oh, even if everybody is would deny you, I will never deny you. He tries to sort of make himself different than everybody else, make himself special. And his big talk, we know exactly where it leads. He goes from talking big to immediately running away like all the others. Although, to his credit, his sort of wonder, his curiosity, lets him sort of lag behind and sort of watch what's happening as Christ is put on trial. So he has a kind of bravery, at least from a distance. And yet, the minute that he's questioned, oh, you are one of them, he denies Christ. He denies him over and over and over again, three times. And so, if we step back and look at what's happening in these passages, I think it's a very powerful thing to realize that when Peter goes out, when he leaves the courtyard, when he goes further away from Christ, that is when he is closest to God. Not when he's sort of lagging behind, half out of curiosity, half out of cowardice, even though he's physically closer to Jesus at that moment. After Jesus looks at him, when he denies him the third time, and he leaves and goes physically further away and weeps bitterly, that moment of bitter weeping is when he was closest to Christ, because that was the moment he understood most deeply his own weakness. And that moment of self-awareness, that moment of honesty, was the moment that he was the most open to Christ dwelling within him. Because when we who are baptized are priests before him, we are also temples where he dwells. And the truth of God cannot dwell in a lie. When we are honest with ourselves and about our own weakness, that is when Christ can live in us the most. That is when we can be closest to God. And so I think we need to follow Peter in not in denying Christ, but in understanding our own weakness and in weeping bitterly over that weakness, so that we can, in our honesty, welcome Christ to live within us.